such a happy individual the moment that you speak. I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I are just like a couple of clouds across the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots. You make me feel so young. You make me feel a song to be sung, bells to be rung, and the wonderful flame to be flung. And in the end, I'm gonna pray. I'm gonna feel the way I do today, because you make me feel so young.
So here's what's gonna happen now. Who out there wants to sing? Hands? I got some people that want to sing. Nobody? Okay, come on here. We're gonna have some screamers get up and sing. Sissy? No? Okay. Alright. One person is gonna sing. No, we're gonna have singers. We're gonna kick it off. What was I gonna say before that? Sorry, I'm a little lost here. What was I gonna say before that? You told me, so. Okay, we're gonna start it off with Pat Dodd. We'll start with Pat. When you get up here to sing, state your name, obviously, and then I want you to say what year you were in the group, and I want you to tell one funny story. Okay?
Make it a quick funny story, because we ain't got all night. Some of y'all know all
it. It's gonna be good. Okay, so let you go, Pat Dodd. Go ahead, Pat. Hey, everybody. All right, so I'm Patrick Dodd. I was in the group 93 to 95. I am Lincoln Pius, the Tin Grad. Exactly, that's about the applause we get for Catholic kids. I don't know a funny story. I mean, I'm sure there were a lot of funny stories, but... Okay, probably the funniest story that I can think of is literally about an hour ago when we checked into our embassy suites. I went, look, I'm gonna initiate this Scarlet and Cream style. So we just happened to be right in front of the elevators. We have windows, and I went down to my skivvies and I was drinking a beer and people were coming by and I was like... You've been in Scarlet Creek, you know exactly. Yeah. All right, we're gonna sing a little country music, y'all.
This song really is going to be intended for those of us who are not here. This song is dedicated to the memory of Ray, Carol, and so many others. It is just one of those moments that, for the majority of our two tables, life has happened. We're catching up on all our medical issues. We're catching up on our children, some of which are 35 years old, which really surprised me. But this piece is just really dedicated. It's a little bit of an Irish folk song. Taking you back maybe to where we were when we were 20. My young love said to me, my mother won't mind, and my father won't slight you for your lack of kind. And she stepped away from me, and this she did say, it will not be long, long, till our wedding day. She stepped away from me, and she went through the fair, and fondly I watched her move here and move there. And then she went homeward with one soft star away, as the swan in the evening moves over the lake. Last night she came to me, she came softly in, so softly she came that her feet made no din. And she laid her hand on me, and there she did say, it will not be long, long, till our wedding day. Thank you, Bray.
Jeff Campbell, right? Jeff Campbell, Jeff Campbell. Do you have a story? Do you have a story? There are so many stories. Just one. Especially from the first year of the group. We went to the Cotton Bowl to Dallas for the game. There was a rainstorm which turned to an ice storm, and it took 22 hours. I had a wisdom tooth that's killing me. 22 hours, vodka didn't help.
It wasn't funny at the time, it might be now, it's just interesting. So if you look up at that picture up there with the colored dresses.
I can find it.
Right, so I'm pretty sure I was probably Ray's biggest problem of anybody in the group, because the problem was, is I was pregnant in that picture, and very pregnant, so my dress is unzipped, and I'm down like this, because I am not as short as Lisa Spomer. This is just amazing to be in the room with all of you. What an honor and privilege just to be with all of you. Yeah. Wait, it's safe to say Ray changed all of our lives, and I always felt like I had such an amazing education between Scarlet and Cream. I think I'm okay. And also, I had the amazing Donna Harder as well. Of us.
lesson. You know what I mean, don't you know? And butterflies are having fun. You know what I mean. And sleep in peace when day is done. That's what I mean. And this whole world is a new world.
Strawberry wine.
story, but I'm not going to name the name of the person that we did this to in the group. But there was a guy in our group. Okay, fine, it was Jason. Jason Valentine. In some small town, I can't remember where it was, we were in this hotel, we were all hanging out in this one room, and we convinced Jason, this is terrible, we convinced Jason that if he allowed us to tie him up in a chair like this, like, I'm in a hook, like this, so we wrapped tape around his arms on the chair, that he'd be able to comp a fetal.
He is doing pliés. window face the main street. We're on the second floor. So then he has the brain, he has the idea. Let's go streaking. Okay, yeah, you do it. Okay, I'm right here. So we're all standing by the door. There's a super long hallway. It's like the Shining hallway. It's like super long. We're all standing. Nelson, Fleeger, I, Ryan, we're all standing at the doorway, and Patterson is buck-ass naked. Hairy ass, by the way. So he's funny. He's standing in the doorway. Nelson and I are right by the door. He goes, okay, I'm gonna run down the hallway all the way and run back. Whatever you do, don't shut the door. Let me say that again. Whatever you do, don't shut the door. He looks at Nelson and I, he goes, get the fuck out of the way. You're not standing by the door. Fleeger, come up here, stand by the door. Because he trusts Fleeger. Fleeger's a Cub Scout. He's an Eagle Scout. Like my close, an Eagle Scout. When you would have him babysit your children. And this guy was an angel. Fleeger goes, oh, I will stand by the door. You guys step back. Okay, Nelson, or Patterson, on the count of three, you run. You guys stay back. I will hold the door open. Patterson didn't get two steps out the door. Fleeger goes, shunk! The next thing we hear is, come on, guys, come on, hey, come on. Come on. So here's Patterson on the Palmer House Hotel, butt naked. We are behind the door screaming at him. He was out there for, what, 10 minutes, probably? Oh, my God, it was the best. That is a tame story. That's my tame story. I have so many stories. Okay, so 20 years ago, I think it was the 30th anniversary, I think, or so, I sang this song. I saw this song performed by Lou Rawls on the, you guys remember the Pat Sajak show? It was on for like 3 months. I happened to be watching one night, and Lou Rawls sang this song, and I went out the next day, bought the CD. Tim Kilgore was in the group at the time. I said, here's, play this song. He didn't even listen to it. He just started playing it. I mean, he was just brilliant. So I had a friend of mine transcribe it, but Sandra, let's hear it for Sandra Cook right here. Sandra Cook. And let me put it. Now, what's that? What? Oh, 3 years. 88 to 92. So my first 4 years in my tenure. Okay, wait a second. You guys saw on the Facebook screen that I'm a bit of a crier. Okay. She's family right here. I love this woman. Yeah. Here I go. I didn't feel this. I wasn't going to do it. I brought my dad's handkerchief. My dad passed away a year and a half. My dad said, I'm going to tell a little story about my dad. Just don't pay your bar bill yet, we got time. My dad and I, he was my best fishing buddy. We were in the boat one year, this was before his 83rd birthday. We're in the boat. Dad says, he goes, I'm going to be 83 years old. I said, that's right. He goes, at my age, he goes, first of all, the life expectancy of a human male in the United States of America is 76. I said, that's true. Mm-hmm. He goes, at my age, there's one consistency. I said, what's that? He said, I can't die unexpectedly. That's a joke. And then he said, at my age, I don't buy green bananas. Hold on, I'm thinking a little bit. He said, I never, ever trust a fart. The one that I never say that I'm going to say in front of you guys, because you're family. You never waste an erection, even if you're by yourself. So. I'm going to try to make it through this song. Because, wait, first of all, how lucky are we? How lucky are we? And I'm serious. Every one of you would be in it 6 years if you did what I did. We traveled the world. We had so much fun. Why is it when you cry your voice goes up? What an evil joke got played on us. Why couldn't it be like,
oh, I'm so sad, baby. I'm so sad.
Sandra, let's take the song, because I'll be on the wrong
trees, the summer breeze, they whispered soft and low. And if I could bring you back again, I'd never let you go. If I was a musician, I would play a sweet love song. Say that I love you. Well, if I were a musician, I'd play my song for you. Cause I love you. Yes, I love you. Maybe I could go on living if you would love me too. I would make him disappear. I would simply snap my fingers and he would be gone from here. I'd wave my wand and from now on you belong to me. Oh, if I were a magician, you'd still be here with me.
And so Ray said, oh, Debbie, he didn't know my name was Debbie. And so he said, Debbie, sing. And I went, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Okay, that's enough. He says, now, dance. And I did a spin, and he goes, well, you can't sing, and you can't dance, but you have great hair that really spins around. So you're in. So that's the good thing.
Yeah, that sounds pretty much like right here.
Yeah, oh, I had a mini skirt on. Anyway, the reason I say we'd like the adults to come to, up to the front is not pejorative. I'm feeling maternal with all of you. I feel like you are our children. We have started something that has gone on and on, and we are so grateful that you have kept the fire burning. And this is for Ray and the 20-year Scarlet and Cream reunion, he said, the only reason I'm mad at all you Scarlet and Cream singers is that you have never asked me to sing. You were the, yeah, you're, and he said, so I'm going to invite myself to sing. And he sang a song that Karen Carpenter sang, and it was written by Henry Mancini, and it's called Sometimes. It's a song I taught him. You're welcome. Ready? We love you.
Sometimes, not often enough, we reflect upon the good things, and the thoughts always center around those we love. And I think about those people
even let me, I spare some.
and west, I've traveled north and south, and from all that I think I've come to know, I'm proud to say that I'm from Nebraska. I'm proud to say I'm from the Husker State. Where they are so famous, not so blue, you'll know it when you're past the bridge of Nebraska. It's my home state. No, I'm beautiful here in Nebraska.
When you really